And now I'm going to give you a bag of shapes. There are polygons in here. There are shapes that are not polygons. There's a whole bunch of different types of shapes. I'm going to give them to you. And I want you, in your table, as a group of tables, I want you to sort them. Do you know what sort means? What does sort mean? Emily? Kind of make groups. To make groups. Kind of put them by type or whatever. I want you to put them in the way it makes sense to you. How does this make sense to you? So sort them in a way that it makes sense. Now, I'm going to give you about 5 minutes to do that. All the members of your group need to agree on your sort. Everybody has to agree, yes, that's a good way to sort them. Okay? And every member has to be ready to defend your sort. Why did you sort it that way? So everybody in your group needs to be able to tell me, why did you put them that in those groups? Okay? Does everybody understand what you have to do? Kennedy, tell me what you have to do.
You have to sort the shapes into piles that you and your group would agree on.
Okay. And what does all group members have to be ready to do?
They have to be ready to defend why you sorted them.
Why you sorted them, okay? All right, so I'm going to go ahead and give you about 5 minutes to do that as a group.
Separate them like in triangles, quadrilateral, pentagon.
So this is four. I also want you to be able to talk a little bit about the properties of each of them. Okay, so talk about that too.
Okay.
You guys have sorted them?
Yeah.
Can you tell me about your sort?
The three-sided ones, triangles, quadrilaterals, pentagons, hexagons, octagons, and no polygons.
Okay, so you kind of sorted them by size. Okay. You all agree on this?
Yeah.
Yes? Can you all defend why you did this? Yes? Okay. And can you all talk about the properties that they each have? So I can pick a shape from your group, and you can tell me the properties of that. All of you.
This looks like a pyramid.
Yes, Jelena? She looks like she's not sure, so you better help make sure you go over that. You got about 2 more minutes. All right, so can everybody have a seat? Okay. So is everybody done? Everybody sorted them?
Yeah.
Everybody's ready to defend their sort.
Yeah.
Okay, so is there a group that wants to defend their sort? Everybody wants to go first, basically. This group right here, Janice, you're going to be the spokesperson for your group. You're going to be the reporter. Tell us about your group. What did they do?
So we sorted them by non-polygons, triangles, quadrilaterals, pentagons, and hexagons, and octagons.
And octagons. So you separated them. So basically you sorted them by number of
sides,
right? Okay. Tell me why you guys decided to do that, Angelica. Can't hear you. So it's easier for you to see them and count them if you sort them that way? Okay. How, Nicole, how did you know if it was a polygon or if it was a non-polygon? How did you know that? How did you know how to divide them? Okay, so she says polygons have straight lines and non-polygons don't. Is that a good way to separate them? Okay, what else can you tell me about polygons? They have straight lines and what else? No, what else? What's another property of a the definition of a polygon? It's a figure with straight lines and what else? Very important. And it's closed, right? It's a closed figure. Okay? Good job. Somebody else want to tell me about their sort? Jeffrey.
We separated ours by polygons and non-polygons, and then we separated it by the amount of sides. And then for the triangles and the quadrilaterals, we separated them by height.
By types. Tell me a little bit more about that.
So for the triangles, we divided them by scalene, equilateral, and isosceles. And then we divided them by angles. So these are right isosceles. This is an acute equilateral, and this is a acute scalene, and this is a right scalene.
Okay.
And then for these.
Let Oscar tell us about the quadrilaterals.
For the quadrilaterals, we divide them by rectangles and squares and rhombuses.
Okay, so you have rectangles, squares, and rhombuses. And Michaela, what do you got there? Trapezoids and parallelograms. And what are those? Okay, a parallelogram has two pairs of what? Parallel lines, right? And what about a trapezoid? One pair of parallel lines, okay. So, okay. Eduardo, tell me about what you got there. What do you got?
We divided them by the sides and what they look like.
Okay. And what do you got there? What kind of polygon do you have?
Triangles and this one's equilateral.
That's an equilateral triangle. Good job. All right. Last table for this part. I want you, the back table, please tell me about your sort.
Ours we separated by the polygons and non-polygons.
Okay. So you kind of did it like this table did, right? There are a table that did it differently. Is there anybody that did it differently? Everybody pretty much separated by polygons, non-polygons. All right, so this is an important step right here. I want you to take all your non-polygons and put them back in the bag.